financial zone, fiscal zone, monetary zone, economical zone. Innumerable zones are there depending upon the person and the intensity and the value of spread of impact. If I am personally having a problem, then it is my financial problem, and if it is so, infinitesimal, it becomes a monetary, and if it becomes a national and policy wise, it becomes fiscal. If it is all encompassing, it becomes economical. Everything is subjected to resources. Everything that depicts the behavioral approach of a person. What approach and what is the type of explanation if you want to get through tension? Economics, it is a wondrous definition of economics. Economics is the pulsation science by which your behavior with yourself, your fellow beings, frustrated beings, society and nation is assessed and reported. Economics is, by means of economic growth, you can understand that you are well behaved with yourself, well behaved with your fellow beings and frustrated downtrodden beings, you are well behaved with the national glory and social pulsation. So that is it. If you are not behaved in such a manner, that results in economic depreciation, debilitation and deterioration or anything else that happens there. So it is a behavioral science. It also gives an idea of four things. One, how you have behaved, you can understand from present, there is part of recording. Number two, from that, the system of rectification, how we have to behave in future with ourselves, that is to be outsourced. Then the third thing is how you have to deal with the admission and repulsion of imitative behavior from others. Fourth, how to set an exemplary model so that you can be good imitation model or role model for other people for behavior extension. These four things are the four limbs of the four pillars of economy. How you have behaved, how you have to behave, how you have to freeze your limitation, repulsion and adoption of other behaviors, how you have to set up a role model of behavior in economy. What is that? It is personal behavior by means of our own purchase, our own establishment, asset synthesis, our own expenditure, and various systems and good explain. Apart from that, I want to throw some new lights on the same economy. Number one is scientific standard of economy. Does economics possess any scientific standard at all? One. And number two, what is the real economy value? Are we seeing the real economic assessment which we are getting in this paper? Articles, symposia, conferences, and various other descriptions? No at all. Third thing, as we are agrarian nature, what about the farmers' rights and what everybody is boasting about the farmers' rights and farmers' privileges and farmers' solutions that are offered by governments? Are they realistic? Are substantive the economy? Are they pseudographic? That we are looking. Fifth thing, is there any availability of any qualitative consideration for professional demographic distribution? Qualitative consideration of professional demographic equation or distribution, is it available? Is there any qualitative training that is available with these people for multi-sectoral progress? These things are the few ideas which you have to consider before coming to the foundation of economics. Economics is not a qualified science as well, standards at all. Most of the people, even the papers, whatever, I don't want to personally emphasize or criticize anything, wherever the paper that we read, they are hardly distinguishable from weather forecast. It is possible, it is expected, it may happen, it has come. Everything is like that. Everything is full of various propositions made upon probability, ambiguity, obscurity, uncertainty, and incongruity. That is the logical status of economics. So, economics is not a qualified sense at all. What are the reasons for that and how to bring the quality precision? It is not qualified, that is, it's a pseudoscience, not like that. As the factors determining economics is connected with collective consciousness, trend variation, and various other absolute properties which are abstract and ever mutable, it is facing three problems. One, unpredictable is the nature of intrusion of nature. Whenever you take into economy, the prefix eco that deals with the natural resources, we cannot predict easily about the nature. So there is a problem in substantialization of the scientific status to economics. And number two, we cannot easily understand about the variations of geopolitical, geopolitical status of other various countries with which we are having trade relations, mutual political relations, and internal relations, mutual exchange, cultural exchange, technical share, technical dispersion, etc. So as the countries which we are dealing with, they are also having uncertainty in determining their political and economical status individually and collectively. That is the second interest. The third thing is, it is very, very hard to channelize the mentality of the public to behave properly in economic honesty and fiscal precision. So, the ground of economics or the politico-economical status of a country is too insufficient and even imbecile to monitor or to lead or to channelize. These three major reasons that will make us to realize that economics is a science, but too unqualified to be called as a precision science because of this unsuitability and chastisability and adaptability and unpredictability of these external and internal factors. So this is the second thing. Third thing, somebody told that a very interesting subject, they have written a book also. Globalization is a big word. And we are aware of poverty. So in the context of globalization, what it is spread to all other places is globalization of poverty, not mere globalization at all. Globalization is a tactics of major power plants of the society to enrich their own economic improvement more by exploiting the temptation and desire drive of developing countries. Whenever you consider about globalization, it includes about only 30 countries. 7 or 8 countries are the major manufacturers, and the India and the Gulf countries, the rest 2 dozens are the purchasers of the same thing. Made by temptation drive, all the other countries, Ethiopia, Somalia, Cuba, innumerable countries are there. Why they are not participating in globalization? Globalization is a tactic tied between some sort of dealing that occurs between developed country, how to utilize or exploit a developing country for that enrichment in the pretext of some technology share, commodity share, trade relations. So this is what we really mean by globalization. You have to understand what is real economy. Real economy reflects, when we explain social justice, we have given one wonderful quotation. What is social justice? There are 2 justices, retributive and contributive. Getting the reward is contributive. Getting the punishment is retributive. If the reward reaches even the last citizen of the nation, and if the punishment is possible even to the highest man of the land, that is not social justice. So economy here, it clearly mentions an area in which the people who are in the lowest standard, they are benefited. Number one, what I want to say here, everybody was talking about Laban family. Who is talking about Laban brothers? What is Laban brothers? Laban brothers. Those who are suffering in the nation. This Laban brothers, nobody is telling that. Company before 1 year, 2015, 2008, it was put into shattered into pieces, there means some economic collapse. Are they suffering for bread now? Lot of people, they have been suffering for so many decades due to malnutrition, infant mortality rate, lack of proper literacy, approach, infrastructure, and proper means of rural environment and empowerment. Other people are suffering. So this recession is understood only when great people they suffer. So it is always defined by economics that the progress is built for the ratio of people to be progressive. So that is not the proper thermometer, that is not the proper pulse rate by which progress and retrogression, collapse and growth, if those things are very much evaluated by a high level of society and their experience, it is absolutely wrong. The real level of economy, that's what somebody told, just as in Christianity they consider the bread and wine as the flesh and bread of Jesus. Anybody who is not participating in social organizations, they are consuming the flesh and bread of the masses instead of Jesus. That's what somebody told. Whenever we are there, not contributing by a prayer, by a coordination, by a possible means, by a democratic agitation or protest, by means of a challenge towards the government to provide everything to us, by sharing of resources, if it is not there, then it is totally unlawful. This unlawful arrangement creates lot of bubbles. Liberty bubble, product bubble, commodity bubble, trash bubble, trend bubble, composite bubble, collective bubble, loan bubble, interest bubble, market bubble, everything passed into recession. So, you should understand the real economy is, let the rich be rich, but it should not be at the cost of